Hi YouTube, this is Geek Teen 2. I'm going to talk about high speed rail. So right now, Canada doesn't have any high speed rail lines. It's the only country of G8 without high speed rail. I think that Canada should use high speed rail like the other members of G8. According to the European Union, high speed rail is passenger rail that operates at least 250 km per hour on upgraded track and at least 300 km per hour on new tracks. They travel fastest on specific tracks with few curves and no at-grade crossings. This is often faster than any other passenger rail except maglev. High-speed trains move much faster than speed limits for cars. Their maximum speed is often slower than passenger jets, but travel times can possibly be shorter for shorter distances. Train stations are often located in city centers, while airports are often located outside cities. Train stations aren't often required to check baggage for security, unlike airports. Another advantage of high-speed rail over air travel is that it generally runs on electricity from overhead lines, as aircrafts generally burn gasoline. Rail travel is also a very efficient way of transportation. The safety of HSR is often better than both car and aircraft, especially when it's on dedicated tracks. The main disadvantage of HSR over air travel is that it's more expensive. Here's a chart that shows how many high-speed rail lines are in each G8 country. I added the most populated countries, China and India, and Spain, which is a large user of HSR, even though they're not part of G8. China has the most, with France in second. This graph shows the total length of high-speed rail in each of those countries. This includes both track in operation and track under construction. China now has the longest length, with Spain in second. Canada has a low population density. This makes it harder to find areas that are suitable for high-speed rail. There have been two proposed HSR lines in Canada. One would be in Ontario and Quebec. It would go from Windsor to London to Toronto to Ottawa to Montreal and then finally Quebec City. The other proposed HSR line would be in Alberta. It would go from Calgary to Red Deer to Edmonton. A few international lines have been discussed by politicians, with little progress. One is from Vancouver to Seattle to improve Amtrak Cascades. I'm in support of this line, and I think that it should be extended farther, if successful. There's many people driving or flying from Portland to Seattle, or the other way around, which makes this a good route for high-speed rail. It could then go to San Francisco to link to the high-speed rail line in California, which is already being planned. That line would be far from now. There could also be an international line in eastern Canada in the United States. In my previous video, I talked about a high-speed rail line in BC, going from Vancouver to Whistler. But this line is unrealistic, as high-speed rail is likely to be too expensive for the area. That video is no longer public. I still think that there should be a passenger rail service going from Vancouver to Whistler available alongside the Rocky Mountaineer. It's both faster and cheaper, but would have to be slower than high-speed rail. A more appropriate option would be diesel-electric multiple unit, preferably running on biodiesel, which produces far fewer greenhouse gas emissions. In 2009, EKOS, Research Associates, asked many Canadians a survey on their opinions on high-speed rail development in Canada. 80% of them supported HSR, 62% of them strongly supported it, and only 6% were against it. High-speed rail started in Japan in 1964, and Europe first used it in 1967. Now it's time for Canada to adopt it. I've decided to allow video responses without my approval to this and all my other political videos to allow people to express their opinions on the subject.